Been on the trail. Been on the trail. Been on the trail. The fine plan of forgetting.
We are really glad to be here to host our 2014 Golden Panda North American International Short Film Festival Cultural Exchange event here at Guangdong Art Professional Technical Institute.
今天我们迎来了来自北美洲的从事微电影创作的各位老师和朋友们。微电影创作也是我们系的一个很重要的教学内容。近些年来，我们的老师和同学们在这个方面进行了大胆的尝试，而且做了很多探索，并且取得一定的成绩。但是，我们的差距还很大。我们需要睁开眼睛看世界。更值得高兴的就是，在这次交流的活动中，我们能看到北美的微电影人他们从事创作的过程和他们很多获奖的作品。这对我们是一个非常好的学习的机会。我相信，这次交流仅仅是一个开端。愿我们和北美的微电影人们携起手来，永远永远的交流下去。再一次欢迎你们。
To engage in this cultural industry, hopefully film industry cultural exchange with us. 各位领导、各位同学，感谢各位在百忙之中成功接待我们下个上来的这个代表团，尤其是电影事业代表团。
And today we're very excited because today we begin the cultural industries exchange between the Canadian delegation and our Chinese friends. 今天我们特别兴奋，为什么呢？因为我们终于可以开始进入这次这个访华的主要目的，就是进行电影事业交流。This is a very important time in modern Chinese and modern Canadian history. The people in cultural industries to get to know each other better, hopefully well enough to cooperate with each other in this expanding global economy. 现在我们的这个中国影视家也是已经认真的在想要参与这个越来越扩大的这个全球化的经济、全球化的经济，也包括文化事业的交流。
我们希望这次的这个代表团所进行的交流，会产生一个比较长期的、互利的、互相有利益的这个电影事业交流。简单跟大家先介绍一下这个金熊猫北美国际微电影节的情况，让大家有一个简单的了解。因为我们金熊猫北美国际微电影节呢，它是一个立足于北美，但是 同时面向中国地区，面向全世界的一个微电影节。那我们欢迎来自各地的微电影人向我们投放这些微电影作品。那我们每年呢，在北美，也就是温哥华，我们会有一个盛大的颁奖典礼。那所有的获奖人呢，他们都会享受一个免费的7天中国这个交流活动之旅。
来到我们第一部影片呢，要跟大家分享的呢，是来自我们北京电影学院的徐磊导演的作品，他的作品在去年 2014金猫国际微电影节赢得的是最佳影片的这个奖项。这个演员都是北京电影学院表演系的学生，都是专业，然后他们都是外地的人，然后强行为我强迫学习的方言。他那个小孩是学表演的一个小孩子。哇！
这是我们的影片的叙事，就会加强它的真实性。后期特别简单，就是每一条都一样的，然后你选最好的把它接下来就好了，掐出去。
This was my final project in film school. We were encouraged to invest
projects that we felt, meant a lot to us. And so I obviously invested myself in directness, and we had 10 other investors from our class. So these final projects were an opportunity for us to do projects that were much larger than we've done before. So this one was roughly $15,000 Canadian. So we had the opportunity to spend more on professional actors and special effects and, much bigger sets.
So this documentary was filmed in Africa, and the name Afrinese comes from African and Chinese. Put it together, Afrinese, because the film is about exploring the Chinese community in Africa. So we mainly went through the East Africa, kind of seven countries, 2 months of road trip.
Hey, this is Eric with CNTVNA.com. I'm here at the Guangdong Arts Professional Technical College, and I'm here with two of the people who just came and watched the screening. What we did is we screened three movies. I want to ask you two, what did you think about this?
我感觉呢，就是学到了很多新的东西吧，就是不只是局限于在我们这个地方能看到的东西，可以看到很多其他的很在海外很新的东西，
给我们的很多启示。
So, I want to ask you, what did you think about the screening?
我觉得因为这次的话我问了很多问题，因为很多问题是跟我专业相关，微电影的这个行业或者是这个拍摄就有更深入的了解。
一次非常好的交流活动，从同学们的精神状态也应该看得出来，大家对你们的到来非常欢迎，而且我想应该是一个好的开端。将来会有更多的这样的交流的机会，我们会更欢迎。
And I want to ask you guys, did you enjoy presenting and showing your screening before all the children?
Yeah, it was really fun and interesting to do that, but it was cool to talk about it in front of a large group and have people actually be interested in it. And yeah, it was cool to kind of share cultures through film.
Fantastic. Yeah, it was fun. It was, you know, it's always nice to showcase your work to other filmmakers and stuff. You know, it's always nice to see your work kind of put in front of other people.
Yeah, it was a great experience for sure to present it in front of all these Chinese students. I think I screened it in Canada multiple times, but it's never been in China, so it's nice to get their kind of feedback and how they feel about it and the trip and our experience and just sharing the story, really. Yeah, it was great.
And Xulei,
how did you feel?
So Anthony, did you enjoy the experience today?
Yes, it was a little bit overwhelming, but very flattering, and it was a lot of fun. Yeah, all the students were just really friendly and enthusiastic and seemed like they were really into their studies, and they just seemed like really great people, so we had a lot of fun, for sure.
So Jen, I have two questions for you. First, did you enjoy presenting to the children? And second of all, what was this musical thing you did? That was amazing.
You have a low threshold of amazement, I think. Yes, I enjoyed the whole session this morning very much, partly because I could tell very early on that the students were kind of excited about it. Excitement is infectious. So I get excited when I see the students are excited, I get more excited. And I see them not hesitating to ask really good professional questions, right? That increases my excitement. So I found it a very satisfying experience. The second, most people know that China is famous for the so-called the Sida Fa Ming, the four great inventions, paper making, movable type print, the compass, and gunpowder or fireworks powder, right? I like to talk about the fifth great invention, which was wrapping. Wrapping, yes, that's right. They use these bamboo castanets to create a lively rhythm. Mm-hmm. And then to that rhythm, you produce a rhythmic, rhymed, kind of fun story. It can be anything from a short thing, like I just did a while ago, to a whole epic. They can spend an entire summer, one episode every night, to do a whole epic. And I have recordings of this, so I find that very interesting. I used to use it as a teaching tool to re-inspire students after they got really bored with just learning textbook Chinese. It's a way of reinvigorating their excitement for learning Chinese.
So we are now at the seafood market. Someone started a fire.
Dressed in white in the night, oh, in the night. The fine plan unfolded, we pried the doors open, and no one saw us around. Someone started a fire. Someone started.
Hey, this is Eric with CNTVNA.com, and we're here at She Fashion Studios. The main creator here is Shio. What she's done is she's been taking traditional Chinese elements, such as a qipao, and she's been giving them a modern twist, very Western as well. So you see this qipao right here? It's pretty interesting, right? It's like the traditional one, but this was very different for the design and, of course, because it's all man-made fabrics. Hey guys, you gotta check out the ladies. They're gorgeous. So together they're wearing about $2,500 worth of clothing. Just, you'll understand, just come see them. Ladies, how do you like this? This is beautiful.
Yeah, it's really pretty. It's not the type of stuff I would normally wear ever, but it's really cool to get to try it on and experience all of this, especially in a different country.
Yeah, I love it because I guess you guys have already talked about it, but it's inspired by the Chinese culture, and so you can see these like elements here, and I guess the material that's used up here, and I guess this is silk. I'm not super sure, but yeah, it's gorgeous. I would totally wear this to, I don't know, a red carpet thing, or you know, things like that in Canada, because you know it represents where I'm from, and also showcases like a great fashion designed kind of taste into it. So yeah, gorgeous, I love it.
So could you please tell me about your fashion design studio you have here?
我的专业其实是那个室内跟软装设计师，就是做空间的，但是因为从小就比较喜欢服装设计这个专业，然后呢，我们的设计风格呢，西是一个独立的设计师品牌，以我的名字命名的。中国是一个最有历史沉淀感的国家，所以我是把东方的元素用西方的结构去做了一系列的变化，演变成了西。
And I'm right here with Ina, one of the runner-ups in the Miss World 2002. Now, Ina, most recently I saw you in the advertisement that was on Times Square. It's trying to promote China. Can you tell me a little bit about that advertisement?
Okay, 大家好，我是吴英娜。这个国家的形象片曾经在纽约播放。这个形象片当中呢，有很多的这些中国的具有代表性的成功人士，包括我们这个时尚界的，所以我非常的荣幸，能够代表时尚界的这样的一个人物出现在这里。
I was told that you're one of the torch bearers for the Olympics. Did you run with the torch for the Olympics? Yeah.
嗯，对的，这是在2008年中国奥运会的时候，我在自己的家乡三亚，作为一个奥运火炬手，并且呢，在非常具有代表性的一个地方，就是美丽之冠的附近，然后举着火炬正在奔跑，我觉得这是一个很难忘的经历。
Today we went to meet some other local filmmakers and actors and actresses and interacting with them and showing some of the movies that we made and getting like pictures with them and just like really merging our cultures was probably the most fun that I had today.
Okay, we've done so many things in the last 3 days, okay? It's really hard to say what really impressed me the most, all right? I have to say that. Maybe it's because it's the most recent, but I really, really had a great time at the institute with the, for the performing arts students and the Cultural Arts Profession Institute students. And I could see that the interaction, we were able to interact with these students, you know, the future filmmakers, for example, of southern China. Mm-hmm. This is a big deal. I think we have a great chance of mutually beneficial career enhancement started here. It was just exciting.
So Colin, how about you? What were your favorite things about yesterday in Shenzhen and today in Guangzhou?
I really enjoyed the, I'm a big fan of, like I've looked into a lot of like the Mongolian history and stuff like that, so seeing a lot of that kind of history represented yesterday in the archery and the yurts and their and just kind of the overall little show that they had going on was really interesting to kind of see, you know, put into real life and you know, amalgamated amongst the Chinese culture. And then today we went to a seafood market that was pretty incredible. You know, we have good seafood back in Vancouver, but it doesn't really compare to having it picked out of the water right in front of you and then cooked fresh. And I'd say it's definitely in my tops of some of the best meal I've ever had, you know, ever. So it was good.
My favorite part was probably the costume dressing at the Minzuchun. My favorite part was also going to the school in the morning and to visit the students there and showing our films and getting a great response from them.
It's a very fun experience for me, especially like being able to kind of bridge up like, you know, the Chinese and the Canadian, just to, so that it helps them to exchange when they're doing their, either they're talking about film or just like they want to talk about food, they want to talk about like what's here in China. It's like, for me, it felt great because like I feel like, you know, I'm being useful here and like it gets to help people understand each other, and like that's definitely a great experience for me. I get confused a little bit sometimes because I'm always going back and forth from like Mandarin to Chinese. So like sometimes I'll turn around to the Canadians and be like, start talking in Mandarin. They'll be like, what are you doing, Michelle? I have no idea what you're saying.
I'd say my favorite thing was seeing the jousting with the horses and that whole thing, because that's really similar to stuff that my hometown Calgary does. And then my favorite thing of today, it's actually really hard to pick because I really liked everything that we did today. Going to the school was really cool. Going to the fashion thing was really, really neat because I've never done anything like that, even a little bit at all. That was really fun to try on all the different clothes and experience that. But actually my favorite thing of today was after the fashion thing, when you guys were continuing to do your interviews, all of us that are like the filmmakers on the exchange went out drinking together. And it was kind of the first time that all of us really got to connect. And even though we all don't speak English or Cantonese or Mandarin, we were still able to communicate and teach each other new words. So, and I think that's kind of the whole point of the exchange, is people getting to learn different cultures through each other. Been on the trail.